What's up, y'all? It's the Majinine. It's time for another one. So, today we're going to do something I haven't done in a while. It's talk a little gaming real quick. In about a month, a little over a month, we have Anthem coming out, which is EA, Bioware's new AAA game that they're going to be putting out for 2019. And I have an article here from Business Insider. And it says, the first major game of the year is a jetpack-powered blockbuster that could take down Destiny. Here's what we know about Anthem. So I'm not going to go over this whole article. I'll just give some bullet points now, and I'll come up with some things that I kind of noticed here, you know, with this game. Basically, this game is going to be a online-only type of game, which automatically there, it lost my interest to begin with. You know, I'm already playing an MMO. If I wanted to play an online version of anything, I'll, you know, an online shooter. I have my Mass Effect. I have Uncharted. I'm really not a POV kind of shooter. I don't like that. That's just me. I like to be a third person. This is going to have basically like a Iron Man-esque type suits. They're called javelins. Looks pretty good. It does. And I'll talk about one of the javelins in here in a minute. But, basically what this is, it's not going to be a MMO or RPG. It's going to have elements of it. So it's going to be almost kind of like an action RPG kind of feel. That's what I'm getting from this article. But the difference is that it's not going to be an open world something like a World of Warcraft or a Final Fantasy 14 type of deal. And it'd be like, you'd be able to interact with basically your teammate for the most part. Like, I guess it's going to be groups of four or eight. I'm not sure about that. But that's the deal with that. Now, the thing about this here that stands out to me is that this is the game that kind of was the crap starter that kind of destroyed Mass Effect Andromeda, because they were focusing totally on this game because they wanted to, whatever their reason was. I don't know how you're going to leave something that is tried and true, which is Mass Effect, and then go with this, which is something that you may or may not know. And then EA hasn't been having the best track record, especially last year. You know, I mean, even going back, I've said this before, going back to Mass Effect 3's ending in 2012, that was a bit of a letdown. That was kind of like, to me, I've said this before, this to me was the start of something bad happening. Now, aside from really Mass Effect, I really don't have that many EA games. I wasn't one of those, I have to have an EA type of game type of guy. You know, I don't do the Maddens or the FIFAs and all that stuff. So to me, this is like really the one thing that I noticed was the start for me. Then when Mass Effect Andromeda came out and you had the crap storyline, the bugs, the character design was god awful ugly. It was the whole thing with the actress that played the female Strider. The female Rider, you know, she's a very attractive woman, and they made the character look like a freaking ugh. Like, what were you thinking? Like, I don't know what that thing was. And you heard the whole conspiracy theories about the quote unquote neo-politically correct, that type of ilk that was like their kind of a deal where over sexualizing games. I mean, like, whatever, it's a game. It's not like this is happening in real life. But that's neither here nor there. Between that and then, you know, like I said, the beginning was Mass Effect 3 with the ending, and then that came out, the Mass Effect Andromeda. Then last year you had the Battlefield 2 fiasco that was all last year. So yeah, you had the Andromeda was the year before that. Yeah, I'm forgetting we're in 2019 already. Beginning of the year, sorry. But so yeah, you had the 2 years before that was Mass Effect Andromeda, then last year was the Battlefront 2, that whole loot box fiasco. So who knows what this is gonna have, because it's probably gonna be littered with loot box deals too, because you know, these companies, I mean, I even fall prey to that too, because perfect example, and I know this is a side note, but we are talking about games. Street Fighter 5. Street Fighter is one of my favorite fighting games out there, period. It's, you can say what you want. I'm a big fighting game kind of guy, but Street Fighter was my number one, because that's way back. That holds a lot of weight for me. When I bought Street Fighter 5, I actually bought Street Fighter 5 with my PlayStation 4 when it came out. I actually waited to buy PlayStation 4 until Street Fighter 5 came out. And when I got that, it was such a disappointment, letdown. And what they did, little by little, they put out DLC here, DLC that. And I've fallen prey to that. I mean, because I like Street Fighter. And they know they're going to have people who are going to spend the money on it, like myself, like an idiot. I will do it. And that's how they make their money. So I'm pretty sure they're not going to stop that practice of trying to milk the customer and giving us an incomplete game. Because I'm pretty sure I'm not buying this game. Just so you know, just to be clear, I will not be buying this game. And I'll get into that in a minute. I won't be buying this game, but I'm pretty sure this game is probably going to come incomplete. I can almost guarantee it. You know, I don't care how long they've been working on this. You know, because you can figure they were working on this when they were working on Mass Effect Andromeda. So that was years of development that they've been doing up to this point. And it's supposed to be coming out next month, February 22nd. So I'm pretty sure this is still going to have some incomplete aspects to it. So back to the point I was going to say with the Mass Effect deal and one of the javelins. So they had a N7 inspired javelin coming out. And it looks pretty cool. Not going to knock it. But here's the thing that kind of made me think about it. It's like, you guys know how well received Mass Effect is, to the point that you put in the N7 armor in this game, but you didn't take the time to do N7 property proper inside the last Mass Effect. I just find that kind of curious. It just makes me laugh, where it's almost something like, kind of like where, and I know it's off topic a bit also, it's almost like how like Disney tells you they want to forget the past, but then they keep going to the past. It's like EA was like, oh yeah, we don't really care about Mass Effect. We can just put whatever out there, and we're going to work on this new project. But then we're like, wait a minute. Mass Effect was an awesome game. It had such a fan base to it. You know, we still got to put some N7 stuff in this game. Put N7 stuff in the game. Put it in now. That's just how I see this. And, you know, I could be just thinking outside the box a little crazy, like. But to me, it's just like, yeah, we don't care about Mass Effect anymore, but we kind of know you guys do, so let's put something in there for that. So, with that being said, I've said this before, and I'll say it again just to make myself perfectly clear, because I'm pretty sure you guys might be watching this, but I know EA isn't, but if they just happen to come across this, I won't be buying anything else, and mind you, it was really only Mass Effect, so you could have had my attention with this, and you could have had my attention with the Battlefront. But because you screwed up Mass Effect, I will not be giving you any money. You don't get rewarded for making bad stuff happen. You see, that's just the deal. There's no reward for just giving us crap. You have to understand that. That goes for all corporations out there. If you think that just because you are where you are, you're where you are because of people like myself and other fans of properties and things like that. It takes the fan / consumer to build you up to where you are. And if you're going to be crappy towards us, it's just not going to give you no money. It's just that simple. Just that simple. So, are you guys excited about Anthem? Let me know in the comments. Like, share, subscribe, and of course, hit that notification button so you get my vids when I drop. I'll catch y'all later. Peace. Come on, top my shit is simple. You got no chance. I exist to trample the weak. What's your cause? Don't speak.